Hey, what up? It's Wallmaker. Today I'm going to show you how I use Sampler when I'm chopping my samples. So with that, let's go ahead and dive in. For those questioning why I use Sampler versus Sampler, Sampler is more of a basic sampler and it handles one sample at a time versus Sampler can handle multiple samples at a time. Sampler is great for sound design among many other things, but for my chops, I go with Sampler. When you first load a sample into Sampler, middle C is going to be where your original pitch is. I then like to tune my samples. For simple one-note samples, you can use the tuner, or you can try something like Auto Key Mobile, which is free. Once you find your key, you can transpose your sample under Controls, and you can transpose right here. On the sample screen, this is where you can turn up or lower your gain. If you want to see both your control window and sample window open at the same time, you can click here, and it also provides a bigger picture of your sample window. I'll go over classic mode first. This is a good mode if you just want to loop something. First, I trim my sample. You can hit loop right here to make sure it loops properly. Now I'll listen to my sample with some drums. You'll notice that the loop is off, and if you want your sample to fit your tempo, you come over here to warp. So now if we listen, you can also speed up or slow down your sample here once you're in warp mode. With these drop-down options, I usually go with Complex or Complex Pro, whichever sounds better. Now I'll go ahead and I'll add a little bit of a filter. Here's your filter slope, your filters, and your circuit type. And now we should just have a simple loop. In one-shot mode, once you trigger your sample, it'll keep playing till the sample ends. With gate, once you let go of the trigger, your sample will stop playing. Lastly, you have slice mode, and this is where you can chop up your samples. This section allows you to chop your samples by transient, beat, region, or manual. You also notice that it defaults to a lot of chops, so if you don't want this many chops, you can just turn down the sensitivity. You have flexibility also. So if your chop isn't exactly where you want it, you can always just move it. If you ever want to add a chop, just double click. If you want to remove a chop, just go ahead and double click again. Mono playback is one key pressed at a time. Poly means that more than one key can be pressed at a time. Through plays through until you press another key. If you ever want to reverse your sample, just go ahead and right click and you can reverse it right here. And then if you ever want to crop your sample, just go ahead and right click also. The crop tool is right here. Another cool thing is once you do have your chops in place, if you right click, you can come down here to slice to drum rack. Now you have your chops independently on a drum rack. So if I want to make this chop longer, for instance, I can go ahead and come down here and extend it out. And if you'd like to pitch any of these up independently now, you have the option to do that. This is one way you can use Sampler, and this is how I use it when I chop samples in Ableton. So if you like content like this, please feel free and like and subscribe. Other than that, peace out.